Hello, I'm Dr. Rashmi Yogish, consultant fertility specialist and reproductive endocrinologist, Kushi Fertility and IVF Center, Bangalore, Karnataka, India. The basic test is semen analysis. The next is the sperm DNA fragmentation. After this is something which is called as a scrotal scan and Dopplers. In men who have reduced count and motility, the reason behind the reduced count and motility could be because of the engorged veins around the testicles, which is called as the varicocele. Varicocele is one reason why the local temperature increases, and that reduces the spermatogenesis. The sperm count and motility drastically come down. In some men, after the correction of the varicocele surgically, there can be a drastic improvement in all the parameters within a span of 3 to 6 months. But in some, however, there wouldn't be any difference despite the surgery, when the reason for all this is not just the varicocele. The sperm count can also be reduced because of hormonal factors. The follicle stimulating hormone is a very important hormone the brain produces for spermatogenesis. If the FSH is rising high and is consistently continuing to rise progressively over the months, then it could be a secondary testicular failure that we are dealing with. As the testis goes into a failure, like any other organ in the body which can fail at some point in time, the FSH starts increasing, and a rising FSH is an indicator for urgent semen freezing, and definitely a procedure called ICSI or ICSI has to be done as soon as possible, because a rising FSH in men can be a pointer towards secondary testicular failure, and a man who was otherwise producing normal sperms is now going to a phase where he might even become azoospermic. The other hormones that can be assessed are the LH, testosterone, inhibin B, and of course the SHBG. The most important ones would be the LH and the testosterone levels, because as the age increases in men, the testosterone levels come down, and thereby the spermatogenesis also goes to subtle downflow. Apart from the FSH, the other hormones that are important for male fertility are the LH, testosterone, inhibin B, and of course the TSH and prolactin. There are several locations where we find that the sperm count is low, but when we check on the TSH and prolactin levels, they are quite high. With the correction of TSH levels with administration of levothyroxine and administration of cabergoline for the reduction in prolactin, have resulted in drastic improvements in sperm counts. The testosterone level reduces as the age increases, and that could be one reason why the spermatogenesis also reduces. We have seen that as the fat increases, as the leptin hormone increases, there could be a reduction in the testosterone and the LH levels, and reduction of weight can bring back the testosterone and the LH levels to normalcy, and the testes would again kick back to function.